This example is if we're not using one of these minis. A mini will give us the distance a half inch off the plane, and therefore we don't need a box offset to get the conduit from the box connector to the plane. In this case, we're going to be using a one-hole strap, which straps that right back to the wall or the surface that you're dealing with. This is a very small offset. The half inch of distance we're trying to create. So we're going to use our card, and our card gives us that if we're going to use a slight angle, such as a 10 degree, which is what I'm going to use, tells us our multiplier is 6. And what that does, that gives us a distance of 6 times whatever we're trying to do. If it's a half inch we're trying to do, 6 times a half inch is 3 inches. And we kind of need that because this hook on these benders, we're going to need at least 3 inches between the two different marks, or we're going to eat into the angle of the first bend. So what we would do with that, we'll get us a piece of conduit. We know that we're going to be right at this box, so we can just come back, and I suggest 3 inches to start any bend. That way you got enough room at the end of the pipe and not get your bender too close to the end. So I'd start at 3 inches, that's my preference. Everybody has their own style once you get into this. But then our first mark will be at 3 inches to start. We'll run this all the way around the conduit. Our next mark will be 6 times, and we're trying to do a half inch using 10 degrees. So 6 times a half inch, obviously, is 3 inches. We take our tape measure. We find 3 inches. Put our mark there. That's our mark B. We've established mark A at 3 inches off the end. Our mark B is 6 times whatever we're trying to do, being 10 degrees. It should be 3 inches because we're doing half inch. Okay, we got our marks now on the conduit. We're going to pick up the bender. We're going to pick up the conduit. We're going to go to a standing position. We've got mark A and mark B, and we measured that with our tape measure pointing that direction with the hook. We're going to make sure our hook on our bender is the same orientation. We're going to pick up and put this conduit into the bender. Line that first mark A up with the arrow. Once we're on the arrow, we're going to pull this down to 10 degrees. Now, 10 degrees is very light. You can see the tick marks on the side. A lot of electricians can do this without thinking. It's a very common bend to do. Most people don't even mark it. They just stick it in a bender and they do it by line of sight and eyeing it. And after you've done this a couple of times, you could do that too, but we're going to go through the full process of putting marks on the conduit, staying with our 10 degree, 6 times our measurement. Our measurement was half inch. Gives us 3 inches between mark A, mark B. We're going to pull this down. We got to do the line of sight because we're going to do it all overhead. So you got to get a feel for it. Again, with the foot in front, the knee behind, kind of a crouching stance, all kinds of pressure here. To pull this down and look at the side as you're doing this to see when we line up with that 10 degree mark. And believe it or not, right there is where my line of sight tells me we're at the 10 degrees. Not much bending at all. Now here is the crucial part. We're going to pick up the back side of this bend, take the pressure off, slide it forward, spin it 180 degrees, put mark B on the arrow, look down the conduit, make sure it's actually straight, eye it up best you can. We don't want it to do a dog leg. Again, with the foot in front, shin behind. Now we're on mark B. We're going to pull it down to 10 degree mark. Just a light pull, and that looks really close. We'll check it to make sure. I can look at it down this way and see it. Look at it down that way and see it. It looks just a little bit off, but I think it's going to be fine. We'll check it with our box. Okay, now we're checking to make sure that it's going to fit where this lays down flat and gets into this connector. is it laying down flat? It looks just a little bit heavy. See how it's kind of raising over here? So what we'll do is we'll take a little bit of that out. Again, that's line of sight. Until you get real comfortable with this, you're going to have to keep checking and checking. It's a little bit heavy. It means we have 10 degrees here, probably 11 or 12 degrees here. So I'm going to go back up and pull a little bit of this out. And all we're doing, just so you can see this, we're going to get on the back side of this bend and pull it out just a little bit. Just kind of set that right on that back side of that bend. Kind of get this hook ahead a little bit, the back side of that bend. And we're just going to pull out a little bit of that bend that we put in it, just a little bit. And that was pulling it out. That's a lot. And now we should be able to fit right in here, all the way up in there, and it lays down flat. And we can put this strap on right there. That's a box offset.